For years, Apple and Android have danced around uniting their ecosystem. With Apple's announcement of FaceTime's entry onto the Android, it seems like the perfect time to bring the most anticipated iOS product, iMessage, into the fold as well. Unfortunately, that's not happening. In this video, we discuss why Apple's iMessage won't make it to Android after all. Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to TechWave and click the notification bell to get notifications on new videos. On Monday, the 7th of June, 2021, Apple announced at its Worldwide Developers Conference keynote that the company was bringing FaceTime to Android users. In what was probably the most surprising twist during the unveiling of iOS 15, Apple confirmed that other operating system users will be able to join FaceTime calls through links sent by iOS users. The move is very unusual, as Apple is known to restrict non-Apple customers' access to its apps. Apple likes to leave a lot to be desired. If Apple lets FaceTime be available to non-Apple users, what other Apple software products may the company be willing to expand? If you ask Android users for the Apple app they'd like to have on their Samsung or Google phone, the answer you get will almost be the same across the board: iMessage. It's a nice dream, it really is. However, it's never going to happen. It doesn't matter how many times Android enthusiasts request it, or how many tweets or Medium posts are written to convince them. Apple will never release iMessage for anything that isn't an Apple device. Here's why. For one, Apple's biggest appeal is its exclusivity. Right from its founding, the brand's position has been firmly established. If you want access to its high-quality software, you have to buy one of its gadgets. The FaceTime decision is the first time Apple has admitted that there may be some benefits to letting non-Apple customers use their products. Still, the company isn't interested in going all the way, particularly with iMessage outside of the Apple ecosystem. And for good reason. When Apple launched iMessage in 2011, it was a response to the popular BlackBerry Messenger. The company wanted one for iOS users and created, as it described it, a messaging service that allows iOS users to send text messages, photos, and videos. And it was that simple, except with more unique, non-traditional features. In typical Apple fashion, iMessage came with a few of its own features that were, up to that point, unheard of. One aspect that made iMessage unique was the fact that it worked over Wi-Fi or cellular, bypassing network carriers. This enabled messages to be delivered instantly, with indicators that showed people responding, and red receipts showed when messages had been read. The app also uses end-to-end encryption, so there was no way for Apple or anyone else to view users' conversations. It was a huge success. At the time, everybody wanted it, and there were speculations that iMessage could be released on Android too. But thanks to new court filings by Epic Games in its public feud with Apple, we now know that Apple made a deliberate choice not to support iMessage on Android devices to keep iPhone users locked into the Apple ecosystem. The court documents included the email conversations and depositions that highlighted Apple executives Eddie Q, Phil Schiller, and Craig Federighi discussing the idea of bringing iMessage support to Android devices. According to the documents, the executives tossed the idea around back in 2016, but ultimately settled on not releasing the messaging platform to an Android version because it would cause the company more harm than good. Eddie Q, Apple's Software and Services Vice President, was quoted to have said that it would make sense to create an Android version of the app so that users of both platforms could exchange messages easily. However, Craig Federighi, Apple's Senior Vice President of Software Engineering and the executive in charge of iOS, quickly shot him down, saying that iMessage on Android would simply serve to remove obstacles to iPhone families giving their kids Android phones. He added that it would be a horrible idea to make it easier for someone to switch away from their platforms. Third-party developers like Epic Games and Spotify have all complained about Apple's total control of its mobile ecosystem, but so far, Apple's complete control has worked wonders for the company. It's been 10 years since its release, and iMessage is probably the most globally used messaging service. And it's not just on the famous iPhones, it's now on Macs, iWatches, and hundreds of millions of other iOS devices. A lot has changed since the app's 2011 debut, but some things, like the famous green versus blue bubbles, have remained unchanged. With the popularity of iMessage, the green bubbles have become even more of a nuisance for Android users. It's hard to miss when an Android user joins a group conversation. That's not an accident, by the way. Again, tooting its own exclusivity horn, Apple separates iMessages from SMS messages with starkly different colors to show who has the good taste to buy an Apple device. Granted, only a few people would care about something as shallow as a green bubble, but the implications loom large. With the population of Android users, who far outnumber iPhone users globally, the effect is felt strongly. Over time, Google has tried to replicate some iMessage features, but for the most part, analysts say Android users who are all eager to gain access to Apple's little blue text bubbles shouldn't hold their breath. According to Jeff Blaber, CEO of CCS Insight, Apple is taking a very pragmatic view on what apps it extends beyond Apple devices. The company was willing to let go of FaceTime because it faced greater competitive pressure from video conferencing rivals. Plus, the product offers more utility if it's available across platforms. The same can't be said of iMessage, which is a deep part of the Apple experience and is the continuity between iPhone, iPad, and Mac. The smartphone giant's grip on its software has loosened over the past few years, though. Its iOS 14.5 software update allowed users to change the default music app to competitors such as Spotify or Deezer. It allows users to swap Safari to other browsers like Google Chrome, and to change the mail client to Gmail or Outlook. Still, while it's willing to let Android apps into its system, putting its own out hasn't always been the same story. Even if Apple decides for some reason to relinquish control, there's one more reason why Android iMessage would never happen. Apple Music. The app didn't do well enough on Android. Sure, Apple Music is an iMessage, but it only makes sense to assume that since Apple Music didn't replicate its iOS success on Android, Apple apps may not be as popular on the platform. It wouldn't make sense for Apple to give up one of its biggest advantages for an app that would probably lag behind its peers in the Play Store. There's no guarantee that the Android version would be as seamless and instantaneous as its Apple counterpart. Features would undoubtedly be held back, updates would be slow to arrive, and ultimately, it probably wouldn't be any better than other Android-based messaging apps. Even on Android platforms, Apple faces competition to iMessage, not just from Google, but also from Facebook-owned WhatsApp. Although Apple has been working to make iMessage more closely mirror social media platforms to compete better, WhatsApp still has one major leg up on iMessage. It's available across various devices, including iOS, making it a difficult choice for people who want to communicate across operating systems. Even if the Android app ecosystem isn't reason enough for Apple to keep iMessage locked to the iOS, then let's consider the financial aspect of things. Apple made more than $89 billion selling iOS devices in the first quarter of 2021, with services, most of which are exclusive to Apple devices, raking $16 billion of the total revenue. While Apple isn't charging for iMessage, it's still a moneymaker for the company, and it stands to lose a significant portion of that income if it allows Android users in on the action. Let's say Apple decides to let Android users in for a $10 a month subscription. With 10 million signups, Apple stands to gain $300 million per quarter. At an average price of $750, that's the equivalent of roughly 400,000 iPhones, or less than 1% of quarterly sales. If Apple phone sales drop by more than 1%, as some iOS users who feel like iMessage is the only thing keeping them with Apple could jump ship to the Android ecosystem, then Apple would lose money. And if there's something Apple hates more than low-functioning apps, it's losing money. So as long as Apple still sells iPhones, it's safe to say that Apple's iMessage will stay locked to the iOS. What do you think about Apple's stance on iMessage? Extreme or worth holding on to? Do you think Apple's going to bring iMessage to Android at some point? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. By the way, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button on TechWave. Thank you for watching. We will see you in the next video.